Hello everyone. Now we are going to look at a numerical on the basis of specific cost of capital. Let us see that how we can calculate the cost of capital for each type of capital one by one. In the first example, we are going to look at the cost of debt at different par values. The numerical is the issue 10% capital debenture for rupees 2 lakhs. Yes, there is an issue of debentures total worth of 2 lakh rupees at 10% rate of interest. The income tax rate is 40%. Calculate the cost of debt if the debentures are issued. There are three cases. One, at par, at discount, or at premium. Discount of 10% and premium as well as that of 10%. Let us understand this question first. See, 10% capital debenture means the interest rate is 10%, the total debt value is 2 lakh rupees, the income tax rate is 40%, and we have to calculate three costs. If it is issued at par and redeemed at par, if the discount, it is issued at a discount of 10%, and if it is issued at a premium of 10%. So in these three cases, we have to find out what exactly the cost of debt would be. Let us go through it one by one. Okay. We know the formula. Cost of debt is I plus P minus NP upon N, where P is your par value or face value, NP is the net proceed upon number of years. Again, P plus NP, that is par value plus net proceed upon 2. Now if you look at when it is issued at par, primarily your par value and your face value and net proceed will remain the same. So P minus NP is P minus P, that becomes 0, and 0 upon N is 0 again. So it becomes I plus 0 upon, now since P and NP are same, so we can write it as P plus P, that becomes 2P upon 2. So it becomes I upon, again this 2 gets cut, so it is I upon P. That's your cost of debt. That becomes the formula of your cost of debt. And again, we need to give the tax effect as well. So after giving tax effect, it becomes I upon P multiplied by 1 minus the tax rate. See, whenever you have to give the tax rate, what you just have to do is, you just deduct the rate of tax from 1. That means in this case, it is 40%. So it would be 1 minus 0.40. And it is multiplied to the cost of debt. The answer you get is the absolute cost of debt even after giving the tax effect. So with this formula, the cost of debt is always post-tax, that we know. So the formula for the same is as follows. Cost of debt is interest upon P into 1 minus T, where KD is the cost of debt, annual interest payment, I, P is the net proceeds, and T is the tax rate. So in first case, debt issued at par, cost of debt becomes, see, the debentures are at 10%, the interest rate is 10%. So 10% of 2 lakh rupees is 20,000. Interest upon principal, I upon P, that is I upon 2 lakhs multiplied by 1 minus 0.40. So 20,000 upon 2 lakhs is 1 upon 10 multiplied by 0.6. So it becomes 0.06, that is 6%. So for a 10% debenture, because of the tax effect, the net practical cost of debt becomes 6% when it is issued at par. When it is issued at a discount of 10%, what would happen is your net proceeds are going to reduce by 20,000. So 20,000 is the interest rate or the interest amount on 2 lakh rupees, but it was issued at a discount, so it becomes 1,80,000. But it is multiplied by 1 minus 40, that is a tax rate, you get 1 upon 9 into 0.6, that is 0.066, that is 6.6%. We are just applying the same formula and nothing else. When it is issued at discount, what difference has it made? Because it was issued at discount, your net proceed has now reduced from 2 lakh rupees to 1,80,000 rupees. It has reduced from 2 lakh to 1,80,000. There is no other change in this formula. Now, if it is issued at a premium of 10%, what would happen? TD is 20,000 upon 2,20,000 multiplied by the tax rate. So it becomes 1 upon 11 because 2 upon 22 is 1 upon 11 multiplied by 0.6. You get 0.054, that is 5.4%. So when it is issued at a premium, the cost of debt has reduced to 5.4%. That's your cost of debt when the debentures are issued at a premium of 10%. When they are issued at a premium of 10%. I hope this is quite clear to you.